Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. I'm Luke Ness Monster, and today this is Ask Luke Ness Monster episode 43, the series on the channel that should have been out on Tuesday, and now it's Saturday and it's finally coming out. But jokes aside, this is actually the series on the channel where I answer your guys' questions from the comments down below. So if you do want your questions answered in next week's video, comment down below in this week's video and I'll try my very best to answer it. And before we do get into the first question, I do want to address the thing with this video being delayed a few days. So I am totally sorry about that. Next week should be back out on Tuesday like normal. So, you know, a few days from now. But So we actually set a goal on the channel to hit 2,500 subs by June 18th. And we've gained 200 subs in like 4 days since then, since I set that goal, which is absolutely amazing. So let's go and let's do it in like another week. Can we do that, guys? I'm pushing ahead the goal. Can we do it by June 2nd, just a random date, June 2nd, can we hit 2,500 subs by June 2nd? That would be absolutely outstanding. I would be super happy, and the reason we're going for 2,500 subs is because at 2,500, we're giving away that Archive Cody in the background there, so if you do want to enter in that, you do have to be sub to the channel, and I do want to explain how that giveaway will work real quick as well. Basically, once we hit that 2,500 mark, we will do a giveaway video on the channel. All you have to do is comment down below on that giveaway video and make sure you're subbed, and that is basically how you enter, and I'll just pick a random comment from that video. So yeah, make sure you like and subscribe if you aren't yet, and on to the first question. The first question says, ask Luke Ness Monster, if you were in charge of exclusives, what would you do differently than that would be a better way than what Hasbro is doing right now? So honestly, if you would have asked me this a few weeks ago, I would have been very mad just because of the Target exclusive wave. But honestly, the distribution and the way Hasbro's actually been stocking these figures has been really, really good. I've seen like probably 500 to 1,000 Instagram posts in the last like week of just people finding these in stores, which is amazing. You know, you barely see, like, if there's a wave of exclusives like this, you might see one or two people find them in stores like that. But there's so many people that are actually finding these in stores. They're being super well stocked, and it's amazing. So honestly, with at least a Target exclusive wave, there's not a whole lot I would change. I know my personal Target has sucked, has not got a single figure yet, and doesn't know when they're gonna get them. But you know, I've seen a lot of stores that have been super, super good with it. But if it was up to me on what I would change, I would make like super popular characters not like exclusives, like Anakin, Obi-Wan, and Echo. Super popular characters should not be exclusives. I'd say like repacks or repaints or variants should be exclusives. Like for example, the Phantom Menace wave that was exclusive to Best Buy, those are all repacks. We've gotten those figures before. That's a great way to do an exclusive because it allows fans that haven't gotten the figure originally to get it, and it allows fans who've already gotten it to maybe pick up another one if they want to. So I think those are absolutely like great figures for exclusives, even like variants. So like, I don't want to say like a Beskar Mando should be a exclusive, but maybe a Beskar Mando that's muddy or something. Like just a little bit of a paint variant might be a good exclusive. Jay Prasad says, if you could make up your own Star Wars villain, what would their name be and what would they be like? So the name would be Lord Mordo, and that's a very long story I don't want to get into right now. And what they would be like, well, they would be witty, what's his name, Thrawn. He would be intimidating like Vader, you know, he'd be super badass like that. And you know, I saw this thing that basically said the three things that make really, really good movie villains. One, you feel for the bad guy, you know, like Darth Vader, you feel for him in Revenge of the Sith because of what he went through. Another thing is you like the character because they're awesome. Like Darth Maul, he's such an amazing character, he's awesome, totally badass, and you know, definitely one of those characters that you love just because of how awesome he is. And then the last type of villain is just a villain that, like, the story writing's so good it makes you hate them as a character. Kind of like Krell from Clone Wars. He's such a hated character because of his storytelling, and that makes a great villain. So if I were to make my own villain, I'd try to incorporate all of that into, like, one super mega character, and I think that'd be really cool to see. The next question says, do you see more clones such as Fives, Jesse, and other clones coming in the future? So I think with this new ARC Trooper Echo mold, it is bound to happen. I think that they've already probably got a Jesse and Echo in the works, probably for 2022, if I had to guess. And of course, the Echo mold does have the like switchable pouch, For whenever they do want to change the mold, I think that's what's going to happen. They're just going to switch the pouch, repaint it. I do really hope that for Fives and Jesse, though, they switch out the helmets, give them the Phase 2 one. I think, yeah, Jesse definitely needs a Phase 2 one. I think Fives, though, should come with two helmets, the Phase 1 and the Phase 2, since his helmets are pretty close to the same. I think it'd be really nice to get that and just, you know, extra accessory from Hasbro that they could include. I doubt this would happen because, you know, Hasbro doesn't like throwing in extra accessories with Black Series figures, but I think that's one I'd really like to see. And then, honestly, I hope we get even more named clones like Phase 2 Jesse, not the ARC Trooper, Phase 2 Jesse, Kix, Hardcase, Tup, all of those. I think we really need just like the entire named 501st. That'd be super great to get as well. Nino Film says, ask Luginous Monster, are there any characters so far from the Bad Batch you would love to see in the Black Series besides Echo? So I really want Echo, of course, because I'm a huge Echo and Fives fan. If you can tell, Echo is in front of you. But if I can't get Echo, I'm going to count this one because it's Echo, but it's not his Bad Batch armor. So it's the droid Echo from the newest episode of Bad Batch. So sorry if that's a spoiler, but he was in the trailer as well, so I don't think it's a super big spoiler. But yeah, definitely him because he's awesome. Besides him, though, I think Omega would be all right to get. We do have her rumored for the future, but I think also like a civilian hunter as well, because, you know, we've seen him in, what, two or three episodes now? That's mainly what he's wearing in the show, so maybe a civilian hunter as well. Simply Star Wars asks, recently watched, or rewatched Clone Wars and realized how key Mother Talzin is. Do you think the Black Series could ever release this? She could come with Dooku, with a Dooku voodoo doll. So, that's a pretty cool idea. I just think that she's such a niche character that they're not gonna make her. Like, I think Ventress is a big enough character that they could make her into a villain. But, you know, same with Cad Bane and Aura Singh, but I think Mother Talzin is just kind of such a niche character that they wouldn't make her. Busby says, ask Luginous Monster, do you think Hasbro will ever make another animated figure line again? So, I think it just depends on, like, if we get more animated TV shows. So, like, they're not going to make, like, the Black Series an animated TV line, but if they make, like, another Resistance TV show, kind of like that, they might have a line of those figures that are in that animated style. So, yeah, I think it could happen. I know Galaxy Adventures is an animated line, if you want to consider that, and those still come out. So, I think that line is getting canceled, but, you know, that's just an example. Hamish asks, great video as always. Question, are you going to try to get all of the 6-inch Black Series Star Wars action figures or just the ones you want? So, as of right now, I'm only buying the ones that I want because I am on a fixed budget. But, you know, one day I'd love to get them all. There's just so many now. I know, like, Hasbro, I believe, came out with over 100 figures in 2019 and 2020 alone. So, you know, I think it's going to be really hard to go back and get some of those that I miss. And, you know, even those ones back in, like, 2014, 15, 16, even some of those are pretty expensive nowadays, so definitely going to be harder to get some of those older ones, but something I'd love to do. Yeehaw asks, what's your favorite Clone Legion? Also, what website do you order figures from? So, favorite Clone Legion is probably the 501st or the 212th. You know, pretty generic, but I do really like them. Other than that, would probably be the Coruscant Guard or, I don't know what else. Yeah, the Coruscant Guard, Shock Trooper, whatever you want to call it. I really like the red color. It just looks super sharp. And what website do I order my figures from? I normally try to get them off of Hasbro Pulse whenever they go up for pre-order. But recently, Hasbro Pulse has been like pretty slow with their pre-orders. I know that the Bad Batch Elite Squad Trooper was supposed to, like, it says estimated release date is June 1st, and that wave initially released in April. So I'm still waiting on that pre-order. I did get another one when it went in stock at a website. I believe GameStop is where it went in stock, and I got it. But, you know, it's just frustrating. Even with the Mando helmet, that one said expected February, and it is now May, almost June, and it still hasn't shipped yet, so I believe they are a little bit behind on their pre-orders. Don't know what's up with that. But yeah, recently GameStop has been a big one. I definitely love. They do a lot of sales and stuff. If you're a rewards member as well, you get tons of points and stuff. You can get free shipping as well, I believe. So, yeah, definitely GameStop has been a huge one because ordering online and in stores, they do a lot of sales, and you can get some figures for pretty cheap. Riggs asks, do you have any custom Black Series? I'm thinking about making a custom Clone Commando. So, I don't have any custom figures. I do really want to make either a custom Fives using that Echo mold, or a custom Commando using the Hunter mold. But the only custom that I've really done is the Echo Shield right in front of you. Really, really great thing I made. Honestly, it took me about probably 3 hours to make. I just cut up some skewers, painted it, and then got a folder-like divider that was yellow, and I cut that out to the right shape. And honestly, I think it came out pretty well. It's not perfect, of course, But I think it came out pretty well. The only custom thing I really have, I do have to say.
Next question says, I wonder when Imperial Crosshair is going to get revealed. My guess for this is probably going to be like early June, because there's supposed to be another Fan First Friday live stream beginning of June. So I'm guessing maybe then is when it'll get revealed.
Hudson says, what is the best death scene from the Clone Wars? So that one's tough. I think it's a tie between Thorn and Fives. I think Fives is such an emotional, you know, you're super attached to the character over that arc, and it's super hard to see him go, because yeah, of course, he is my favorite clone trooper. But Thorns is just so cool, because, you know, he's such an amazing character, and he goes out there and bravely dies, you know, throwing around that giant minigun. It's just awesome. So definitely a tie between those two.
Orange Sus says, do you think that we could get a Black Series Jared to Paul in the Gaming Greats line? I really hope we do. I think that'd be super cool. I think they could reuse some parts from Zeb. And now we have those like a Clone Wars kind of molds for the armor there with the new Anakin and Obi-Wan. I think that this would be a super cool character to get. Honestly, I think Jared to Paul is awesome. From, of course, Fallen Order, and I'd love to see him in the Black Series.
Ben says, do you think they'll ever make a Bib Fortuna from The Mandalorian / Book of Boba Fett? And do you think we'll ever get a Boss Nass? So I'm not going to answer the second question, but the first one, I think we're not going to, because he was in it for like 3 seconds and then he died by Boba. I think we might get like a Boba and his throne, but I don't think we're going to get Bib Fortuna.
And Goose says, ask Luminous Monster, why does Black Series appeal to you more than 3¾ inch?
So originally when I started, it was the only stuff that was really on the market, because I started late like 2019, and I wanted stuff from Rise of Skywalker and Mandalorian, and those were the Black Series was the only place that had it out yet. So of course I got Black Series, and then I just got my collection so large I kind of didn't want to switch over to TVC. And plus, Black Series right now seems to be making a lot more figures than TVC, so I'm kind of interested in that as well.
David Tom says, what character / version do you think would never made into a Black Series figure, or be made into a Black Series figure?
So I've answered this before, but I think it'll be a charred up Anakin from Revenge of the Sith. I just think, you know, it's such a graphic figure that, you know, it was all right in 2005 when the movie came out, but now that Star Wars is owned by Disney, Disney would not allow Hasbro to make this type of figure, I don't think.
And then the last question for today, what are your Desert Island top 5 Black Series figures? That's a great question. Top 5 as quick as I can: Echo, Rex, 332nd, Crosshair, and what's one more? Of course, Boba Fett, the new Return of the Jedi Boba Fett. Those would be my 5.
And that is going to do it for the video. If you enjoyed, that like button and subscribe if you're new to the channel. Like I said, we are going for 2,500 subs on the channel, so please hit that subscribe button. I would greatly appreciate it, and I'll see you guys in the next video.